The Harlem Fine Art Show is the largest traveling African diasporic art show in the country. The theme of this year's tour is the healing power of art. And once again, the four-day exhibition and sale will be staged here at the historic Riverside Church. With us today is HFA founder Dion Clarke and world-renowned artist Leroy Campbell. So nice to have both of you here this afternoon.
The privilege is ours.
So did you guys coordinate these glasses, these very colorful?
You go first.
We had to have some synergy.
We're
in sync.
So how many years is it now?
We're going on our 9th anniversary coming up, and it just seems like yesterday, but we are excited because we got a great show this year.
Yeah, so what's new, most new and most exciting about this year's 4 days here in New York?
Well, we're working with the South African government, mm-hmm. and for the first time, they're sending over 14 of their emerging and career artists to exhibit and sell their works for the 4 days in one of our towers during the Harlem Fine Art Show. They'll speak about South Africa, they'll show you their works. Some will actually be painting live on at the experience of the Harlem Fine Art Show. So we're excited about
this. It's truly international.
For sure.
And absolutely. This wonderful man here, Leroy Campbell, I want to say, what haven't you drawn?
Wow.
I love looking at your works.
Thank you.
And I've always loved them so much because especially the drawings that feature black women and little black girls.
Absolutely.
They're just wonderful. And you, there are a lot of your works that the background is newsprint.
Absolutely.
And I love the way that, you know, it's juxtaposed against, you know, whatever's at the forefront of the painting. I just think it's wonderful work.
Well, I appreciate that. And
yeah.
Because this year marks 35 years.
Mm-hmm.
That I've been a self-employed artist.
Yeah.
I've never starved. I don't believe in the starving artist concept. I think it's overrated.
Yeah.
But this has been a gift given to me,
mm-hmm.
and from the gift giver. And I know every time I sit before a painting, a canvas, I always pay my respects.
Yeah.
And so there, whereby I get to prosper. And one of the things about this year, I have this theme, which I've come up with, called The Journey Continues.
Mm-hmm.
So what I'm doing is putting newspaper articles in the artwork to give the viewer images of people who have continued to move forward, even in times worse than these, right?
So it's given real context.
Real context, and then I've made it thematic. Right, speaking about family, and in the family, the relationship between the mothers and the daughters, this is the year of the woman, is very prominent.
Mm-hmm.
So all of that is put into the work, not only over the 35 years, but at the Harlem Fine Arts Show, to tell the viewer, this is something for your fire to keep you going.
Yeah.
And I am so happy to be a part of the Harlem Fine Arts Show this year, because we're going to be connecting with so many other artists who are gatekeepers of the culture in that way, and the spirit.
And that's how you see yourself, as a gatekeeper of the culture.
Absolutely.
And you think the show, is important in terms of, you know, reminding people of color, how much they've offered to the culture, I guess you could say. I mean, we talk about this, this being the full breadth of the African diaspora. Does a show like this, you think, give folks a really good look at how much art, how many artists are out there, artists of color, and what that word art means? And it means so many things, and it's such a broad term.
You want to take that?
Well, I think it does, because first of all, this is our 9th year, but we have 80 artists and galleries on premise to be able to really develop what we call that cultural nutrition component,
mm-hmm.
the opportunity for everyone to, again, reestablish some of the thoughts, develop relationships with the artists, and continue the journey. And I'm taking that a little bit from Leroy, because our journey is always continuing. It's so important that we hold hands, especially in days and times like we're having right now, and for us to get a good understanding of politically what's going on, socially what's going on, and how we can develop relationships with the civic, social, and religious aspects of our lives on an ongoing basis.
And to that end, the theme, the healing, what did I tell you? What is that?
The healing of art.
Thank you. And
it's the healing of art and how it impacts us on an ongoing basis. And last year, we were just really trying to strive how it's so important to salute the individuals mm-hmm. who are not saluted on an ongoing basis.
Yeah.
We salute the athletes. We salute the celebrities. But here are the doctors who are saving our lives and saving our communities. We need to, again, have some reverence and salute them, and also show the importance of how they heal us on an ongoing basis. And Leroy can really kind of really expound upon that point a little
bit.
Well,
you know, when I think about the gatekeepers of culture, I think that the bigger picture is not only to use to present the culture and say that this is what's good about this particular group of people, but that this group of people, culture is so necessary for the health and wholeness of the humanitarian ecosystem.
Yeah,
all the cultures. You see, it's almost like what I think our art has always been about, our culture has been about, was to say that here we are sharing this garden together, mm-hmm. all of these different plants, right? And if I'm healthy and if I'm at my optimal health, then whatever nourishment I have for the soil that you are sharing with me, now I can strengthen your health.
Yeah.
And so together, if we are both healthy together, we make this eco-humanitarian system environment better for everybody, so mm-hmm. everybody benefits. So it's to our advantage that every culture be 100% potent and strong, because every other culture that's connected to it and sharing the atmosphere
depends on it.
Mm-hmm. And that's the bigger part of culture. It's not just a pro-black thing. Yeah. It is a humanitarian picture that we've been trying to cultivate and fuse ourselves in as a benefit to everybody.
And you can see that also in the audiences that have come to the Harlem Fine Arts Show.
Yeah, it's a real mix.
When we started out, it was, again, a large percentage was just African American. We have a tremendous general market type of population, mm-hmm. Latino, Asian, and it's really a melting pot, and it's a fun experience.
Yeah, I think that speaks to the quality of the art, quality of the show itself. I wanted you to touch real quickly on some of the other components that you have. I know you give out scholarships.
Yes.
And there are also some workshop opportunities during the 4 days.
Well, this year we've expanded with that health perspective, so we were able to work with Black Health Matters, and that's an organization that is doing a workshop or a symposium on Saturday over the 4 days of the Harlem Fine Arts Show, and they're going to be talking about health in our communities and how to become a little stronger mentally, physically, fighting cancer, all the different components. And then you come over to the art show as an added value, or vice versa. You can go and intermingle in between.
And to reinforce that message, part of my collection will have a body of work that focuses on African Americans in medicine.
Okay, in fact, that was my next question to you. What pieces of art from you specifically might we see?
For many years, I have this long, ongoing relationship with the National Medical Association's African American doctors, and I've been doing the cover journal for the Women's Physicians Luncheon, and I've come up with a series that deals with medicine, because you see, that's also, these themes include, of my work, include the medical series, the family series, our educational and political series, and these are our foundation. If we're going to move forward to be a healthy, whole component in this garden, mm-hmm. Part of it has to be our health. We can't be a sick people trying to accomplish anything. You have to carry your physical self and optimal health. And one of the things I love about having my relationship with the medical, so it's that many of them are focused on reaching into the community and trying to help people become conscientious of their diet, of exercising, going to the doctor. So there's a lot of African American doctors who are adamant about trying to make sure that the community that I'm speaking about becomes as healthy as possible. So paying tribute to them is befitting, and it's a call to action.
All right. I'm going to have to cut you off because they're telling me I'm running out of time, okay. And I want to get the information out. The show is from the February 15th, runs through the 15th.
Through the 18th. Yes.
Admission is $25, right?
That's correct. And we have partnership evenings every night from 6 to 10 where there's a great celebration, and then everybody can come in and get a chance to rove throughout the galleries itself. And then we have something new. We have something called the Harlem Book Fair. Max Rodriguez, and he's partnered with us. And the books and the art, authors and arts, they just blend together. So with health, authors and arts, and then
a little bit of everything.
And a great weekend just in store for you.
Thank you both for being here this afternoon. I might mention my colleague, Rob Nelson, is going to be helping you out on opening night.
Yes.
All right. He's
taking your place this year.
He's a fun guy. But we hope to have you back soon.
You'll
never want me again. He's really great. Thank you.
Thank you for the opportunity. We appreciate it.
My pleasure.